Hi there, I'm John Bond from Riverwinds Consulting, and this is Publishing Defined. Today I'm going to talk about a hotly debated topic, Plan S. Plan S is an initiative for open access science publishing that was launched by Science Europe in September 2018. It's an initiative of Coalition S, a consortium launched by the European Research Council and national research agencies and funders from many European countries. The plan requires scientists and researchers who benefit from state-funded research organizations and institutions to publish their work in open access or OA repositories or in journals by 2020. The principles behind the plan include 1. Authors should retain copyright on their publications, which must be published under an OA license. 2. The members of the coalition should establish criteria and requirements for compliant OA journals and platforms. 3. They should also provide incentives for the creation of compliant OA journals and platforms. 4. Publication fees, or APCs, should be covered by the funders or universities, not individual researchers. 5. Publication fees should be standardized and capped. 6. Universities, research organizations, libraries should align their policies and strategies. 7. Compliance for books and monographs might go beyond 2020. 8. OA archives and repositories are important to the future. 9. Hybrid OA journals are not compliant with the key principles. And 10. Members of the coalition should monitor and sanction non-compliance. There is wide membership in the coalition, including many that now express support for the effort. These include many national research councils and organizations in Europe and beyond, as well as the Wellcome Trust, the Gates Foundation, Spark Europe, OASPA, and others. China and India now support the effort. The supporters cover 6 continents and is changing as we speak. Go to coalition-s.org for the latest updates. There are specific implementation guidance at the website as well regarding the transition period, green open access, licensing and rights, and the mandatory criteria for OA journals and platforms. These journals and platforms need to meet specific criteria to be compliant with Plan S. This criteria includes strict adherence to immediate accessibility of content, be compliant with the Committee of Publication Ethics or COPE standards, be listed in the Directory of Open Access Journals or DOAJ, waive fees for low-income countries, issue DOIs, participate in locks, clocks, have the full text content accessible to foster text and data mining, and others. As of early 2019, there's a host of reactions to the plan. For-profit publishers push back on the idea, saying, quote, it potentially undermines the whole research publishing system, unquote, and that it, quote, will not support high-quality peer-reviewed research publication and dissemination, unquote. A spokesman for Elsevier said, quote, if you think that information should be free of charge, go to Wikipedia, unquote. There has been heavy support from funders, national research agencies, and some author groups. Some other organizations and some author groups have come out against it, however. There is a lot more to be written about this plan and its eventual effect on scholarly publishing. There's no doubt, however, that initiatives such as Plan S are dramatically reshaping scholarly publishing. What's your take on it? Well, that's it. I'm a publishing consultant and work with associations, publishers, and individuals on a host of content-related issues. Reach out to me at riverwindsconsulting.com with your questions. Hit the like button below if you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel or click on the link to see my video about open access. And make comments below or email me with any questions. Thanks so much and take care.